guys, welcome to another episode of Get Wedding Ready with me, Wura Manola. Today, the video I have for you is how to choose your wedding venue, what kind of questions should you be thinking about, you know, when choosing your wedding venue, and also I'm going to give you tips on how to bring your wedding venue to life. If you want to see how I transform my venue from this to this, then keep watching. The first thing I'm going to do is just tell you the types of wedding venues out there. So the first type of wedding venue out there is a hotel. Hotels are a really, really good space for weddings because they're intimate. If you want that intimate feel, if you want the space to be just yours, they're one of the most popular wedding venues. Hotels are really for simple, elegant, really nice, intimate weddings. And hotels tend to have a capacity. So it's only very limited hotels have capacity for thousands of guests. Some hotels are not flexible. So some hotels will not let you bring in your own food. Some hotels will not let you decorate the hall the way you want to, just to make sure you don't, like, you know, break anything or mark anything on the hotel. So it's something you need to bear in mind, you know, when choosing a hotel for your wedding. If you're thinking of using a hotel for your wedding, just make sure that you know what you want for your wedding and the hotel is accommodating, you know, all your requests. The next venue type out there is a hall. Halls are popular because they fit thousands and thousands of people. A lot of people who want to have big weddings tend to go for halls. And the good thing about halls is you can bring anything. Even if you want to bring a car, even if you want to bring a crane and come out from the sky, like, you can do anything you want to a hall. It's so flexible. So if you're the kind of person where you want absolute flexibility and you have a lot of people coming to your wedding, then a hall is a preferred type of venue for you. The third type of venue we have is a marquee. Is a marquee, whatever. It's a marquee. So a marquee is literally like a hall, but it's outside. So it comes in a tent. Marquees are really, really good for big weddings as well. The difference between a marquee and a hall is that a marquee is literally set up and it's usually outside. So it kind of gives you the feel of an outside wedding and it's usually open. So a section of it will be open so you can, you know, feel the breeze and, you know, look outside, especially if it's near the beach or if it's in a garden. Marquees are so beautiful for that outside feel without being outside completely. If you're the kind of person, you want an outdoor wedding, but you don't want your hair flying in your food, or you don't want flies in your face on your wedding day, then maybe choose a marquee. And marquees are really intimate as well because you can, you know, put your own touch to it, decoration wise. So the next type of venue we have is a beach venue. So a beach venue is literally just chairs, an aisle on the beach. There's really nothing too fancy, nothing too technical going on there. They literally just have chairs, an aisle for the couples to say their vows and everything. So it's one of the most simple wedding venues to choose. Beach weddings, I would say, weather-wise, you have to be sure it's not going to rain on your wedding day. So you absolutely have to have your wedding when it's dry season and it's not going to rain. That's what I would recommend for beach weddings. So the next type of venue we have is a townhouse. So the difference between hotel and townhouse weddings, townhouse weddings are literally in castle-like buildings. They're usually old built, this beautiful ancient feel. So townhouse weddings are usually small amounts of people as well. They're really simple and elegant as well. Townhouse weddings would not take, you know, people into the thousands. So if you're having a big wedding, the probability of getting a townhouse that will fit your wedding is literally very slim. If you're looking for a simple and elegant feel to your wedding and you have small amounts of people, a hotel is perfect for you and you don't mind, you know, flexibility on bringing food and all of that. If you want a lot of people at your wedding and you're going to bring your car in there, someone's going to come from the sky and all of that, a hall is perfect for you because you can do anything you want with that. If you want a huge wedding as well, but you want it outdoor, but you really don't want it distracted by everything going on outside, a marquee is perfect for you that opens up, you know, to the outside in the garden. And if you're the kind of person where you want the castle feel, you want something really, you know, princessy, then a townhouse and a castle is perfect for you. So now that you know the type of wedding venues out there, the next thing I'm going to talk to you about is the questions you have to bear in mind before you choose your wedding venue. So the first question is the size. The size is so important. Size was such a big factor when I was choosing my wedding venue. I wanted a wedding venue that I could accommodate, believe it or not, just 150 people, and there weren't many hotels in Newcastle at that point that had that capacity, and the ones that had it were not that flexible. So you want somewhere that can accommodate the amount of people, you know, you're looking to have at your wedding. So size is really, really a huge factor, obviously, when choosing. I have my phone here again, so I'm just gonna read off it. So if you see me look down, just know it's this. All right, so the next thing is flexibility. As I've said in my previous video, flexibility is such a huge factor when dealing with your wedding venues. Your wedding venues have to be flexible, meaning you can bring in anything, your food, your drinks, means you can bring in your own decor, you know, you can put your chandelier, you can do anything you want. It's so important for you to choose a wedding venue that is flexible if you're thinking of having a lot of, you know, decor ideas, and if you think of having your own food and your own drinks. Location and accessibility. Wow. So this if your venue and your church or wherever you're coming from is 2 hours apart, it's just not going to work at all. It's very important for your reception venue to be close to the church or wherever you're coming from. If not, it's going to be very difficult to get there, and people are going to turn late, and you might be late as well. Accessibility is so important for people to be able to get to your venue. If people need a plane, a train, a canoe, and to cross as well, a bridge to get to your venue on an island in the middle of an ocean, it's not going to work. If your venue is somewhere that is not accessible, if it's like outskirts, it's a factor for you to consider, because a lot of your vendors would easily deliver their items that you need to somewhere that is really central. So I know that the most central places are really expensive, but if you can, make sure your venue is accessible. The next thing that you need to be thinking about when choosing your wedding venue is timing. Timing is so important. You should be able to use your wedding venue till the wee hours, as we call it in England, like late. So you should be able to use your venue till 12 a.m. or 1 a.m. Any venue that tells you they're shutting at 6 or 7, it's like, when are you going to turn up? Turn up starts at 10. So your venue should be able to accommodate your turn up. You literally need to tell your venue, I need to turn up. You need to give me this venue till 12. So timing is so important. You need to know when you have the venue from and to. It's so important, because if you go over the period that you have for your venue, you're going to start paying, and you'll probably pay for like the next, you know, block, like maybe a full day or a half day. So it's so important for you to, you know, get the timings right and know what timings you're paying for. The next one is control and privacy of the venue. If you're not really bothered about, you know, privacy of a venue, if you don't mind if a funeral is taking next door, or you don't mind if, you know, there's a swing party happening next door, yeah. If you're not that kind of person that you care, you just want to have your wedding in this place, that's fine. But for people out there who want, you know, privacy at their wedding, they want the whole, if possible, the whole floor of the hotel or, you know, area there to be theirs, you know, then make sure that you can have that. So now that we know the types of wedding venues out there, now that we also know, you know, what kind of questions to ask, you know, before we choose our wedding venue, I just wanted to give you guys some quick ideas on how to jazz up your wedding venue. The first thing that you could use to jazz up your, you know, wedding reception is a stage. A wedding stage is just literally a stage where you and your husband stay, sit. Some people have top tables where, you know, the whole family sits, whatever, you know, floats your boat. You can have a top table, you can have a stage. That's really good, because that sets you apart from the rest of the floor, and then you're central and everyone is like focused on you. So it's so important for you to get a stage for your wedding if you can. The second thing I would say for you to jazz up your wedding venue is drip your venue. Oh my god, dripping your venue is so important. I think any venue you use, you should be able to drip it if the venue is not pretty. So if you're using a conference room, if you're using a hall that just has white painting, dripping is such a lifesaver, because dripping just makes it look so much more beautiful. I have a picture of my venue that was dripped down. So it's extra cost, but it's, trust me, it's so beautiful for you to drip your, you know, wedding venue. The next tip I have for you to jazz up your wedding venue is mood lights. So this works with draping as well. When you drape your venue, you put the mood lights, you know, at the back of the draping, and obviously the white draping reflects the light. You put that all around your venue and it's so dreamy, it's so beautiful. I had that at my wedding and it was stunning. The next one I have for you is centerpieces. The next thing I have for you is centerpieces. Centerpieces are so important. Invest in centerpieces. Oh my gosh, the higher and the fuller they are, the more beautiful they are. If you don't have a lot of money for fresh flowers, I've talked about this in my last video, you can use fake flowers or you can use chandeliers like I've used at my wedding. They're inexpensive, you can rent them and return them. Oh my god, you have some centerpieces at your wedding, it lights up the whole room, trust me. It makes such a difference. And you can have different things. You can have one table flowers, the other table chandeliers, you can have one other table, you know, with just a structure of something like a tree or something. So invest in centerpieces. So the next thing is flowers. Flowers just make a difference. Weddings are known for flowers. If you have money and you can invest in flowers. Oh my gosh, your venue will be so beautiful. Candles. Oh, candles are so beautiful. So when you have your centerpieces, you put little tea light candles on the table. Candles are very romantic. There's a reason why you light candles to, you know, for that feel. So if you have like 100 to 150, 200 people at your wedding, or less than 300, I would say definitely have candles at your wedding. Light them up and they just give you this really nice feel at your wedding. Next is chairs and bow ties. I absolutely am not a fan of the chairs in hotels that have white covers and you tie the bow. I'm sorry for anyone who's used them who likes it. This is just my opinion. I literally don't like them. I love the chairs, the one you can see on the screen right now. They're so beautiful, they're so elegant, and you can tie whatever bow you want, or you could just leave them the way they are. Sweet and dessert table. So sweet and dessert tables are just an addition that you can put for your wedding, and they just look really beautiful, especially if you have like glitter cakes or like pink. And sweet and dessert tables are usually really colorful, so they just add life to your wedding, and you can put your initials on them as well, which is beautiful. The next one is balloons. Love balloons, or balloons of your initials are so, oh my god, so beautiful. By the way, if you're watching this video and you live in England and you want love balloons, the one on the screen right now, hit me up and I'll send it to you for free. I had it for my wedding, but I didn't end up using it, so I've got a spare for anyone who wants it. Dance floor LED lights or initials. LED lights are so beautiful. I think they jazz up your wedding reception even more. They just make it so gang-gang, just make it so like, make it so dreamy. I think invest in LED lights for your dance floor. Or want something so you can have your initials monogram like stuck. You can have your initials stuck on the wedding floor, the wedding dance floor. It's a hard day, guys. It's a hard day. Almost coming to the end, guys. I've got three more ideas for you to jazz up your wedding reception. The other one I have is a games table. You don't really need this, but I thought it was a really good fun activity. You can have a games table at the end of the hall. You can have pool table or something where, you know, when it's time to, you know, party and everything, people can do different things, especially if some people just don't like dancing, some people just want to do other things. Your seating plan. Your seating plan is the first thing people see it and to see where they're going, so please make it beautiful. You can use a mirror, you can use like, you know, something that has flowers all over it. So yeah, you can definitely jazz it up and it will look beautiful. Red carpet is so exclusive. Having a red carpet like drips to your reception, people walking through, everyone just feels like a star. Who doesn't want to walk right down a red carpet? The last thing I wanted to talk about is love lights. Oh my god, I love love lights or initial lights. Love lights and initial lights are such a cool addition that you can add to your wedding that makes it look so beautiful. And initial lights are so beautiful as well because they're very personal. Your initial and your husband's initial at the wedding, we had that at our wedding and I absolutely love them. Your cake table, oh my gosh, how did I forget? Sorry, the last one. Oh my god, guys, there's so many ideas, but the absolutely last one is your cake table. Remember, that's where your cake is and it's a focal point after the stage. So you want to make sure your cake table is decorated. You can put your table on a cloth and you can put flowers all around it, or you can have flowers as the cake table, you know, we've seen that, or you can have it suspended. Whatever you do, invest in making your cake table as beautiful as it can so that it can, you know, stand out. These are my ideas of how you can jazz up your wedding venue. Absolutely invest in draping your wedding venue. You know, if the wedding venue itself is not pretty enough, definitely invest in mood lights, logo lights if you want, you know, your initials to pop. Definitely invest in a stage, and definitely invest in centerpieces and balloons. There's so many things, honestly, guys, the list goes on, but I just thought to just give you my favorites out of all of them. So guys, these are my quick ideas to help you jazz up your wedding reception venue and to make sure that it stands out. I hope it has helped someone, you know, be very creative and think about how to, you know, make that wedding reception venue pop. Thank you guys for coming by my video. Please like, comment, subscribe to me and come back and keep coming back for more. Let me know if you want me to make any videos, if you're planning your wedding, have any questions, send me an email or comment down below and I'll be sure to answer them. So this is Wura Manola. Thank you guys so much for watching my video and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye.